Okay, so first thing you need to do is go to Blender's website, go to Downloads, go to Demo Files, and you will see just bundles. You will need this one. If you click on it, it will automatically start to download it. There will be a video on how to install it. It's going to be a bit different than the normal add-on. Okay, so once we are in Blender and you successfully installed the asset bundle, we can just delete this, open a new window, and look for an asset browser. Now you're supposed to have all these new meshes. What we are looking for currently is a body female realistic one. So we are just drag and drop it into the scene. Very important thing, you should uncheck this instance. Okay, now we can close this window. We uncheck it so we can modify the mesh itself. Okay, so first thing we need to do is present the location of the character so it will be snapped in place like we want it. So if you need the eyes, don't touch the eyes currently, because as you can see the relation lines, it means that it is parented to the character, as you can see it here. So we don't wanna reset this location, because if we do so, then it will snap in a weird place that we don't want. So I'm just gonna undo this. We're gonna select the character, then we are gonna press Alt H, then we reset its location. Now we can go into the eyes, of course if you need them. So we are selecting them, and we are going into parent and clear and keep transform. Now we can go to the object, apply all transforms, then we are gonna set origin to geometry. Now we are all good to go. Now, so once we have this, we can go just shift A, armature, rigify, and we're going and add a human one. Now, what we need to do here is, first thing is go to viewport display, and going in front, we are gonna scale it accordingly, going into side view, and just slightly measure it, like so. Okay, now we are going into edit mode and we are going to snap in the mirror and we are gonna quickly align these. What you have to take caution is that joints like this, when they are all stick together, you should not supposed to move them one by one. So you just circle select and select both of them. Now, once we are all set and done, we will just going to delete the face balls because we are currently don't need them. Let's check that only the face balls are selected. One thing you have to keep in mind that you have to delete the face ball as well, otherwise you will get errors. And the only way to see this is going into wireframe and we'll see this one. And you need to get rid of this one. Just a few minor tweaks. Okay, once we are done, now we can just go into object mode and we have to apply the scale of this armature, because if you generate the rig right now, then it will be bigger than what we expected already, what it should be. So we're going to object, apply all transforms. Now we can go and generate rig. Now we can hide this. Now we are going to select the eyes if we need them, the character, then the rig. Going to Ctrl P, it automatically waits. Now it should all work. Oh, I forgot to mention that the character itself has a multi-resolution modifier. So what we need to do here to work efficiently is to just turn it off. And now if we are going here, it's all working as expected. So there you have it.